Now I return to the prophecy of Hosea. You've listened to a message that we gave some time ago as a sermon, but we felt it furnished a proper introduction to Hosea. This man is a remarkable prophet, and I personally do not like the classification of major and minor prophets. Actually, that was put in by the church, I suppose, about the 3rd century. It was not that way in the Hebrew Bible, and Hosea was just put with the other prophets and was not put last in the Old Testament. If they had waited until I got here to make an arrangement of the books of the Bible, I would have made the arrangement of putting the prophetic books with the historical books, the ones they belong with. And have you noted that practically all of the writing prophets, their message belongs to the divided kingdom? When the kings fail, God raised up prophets to speak to the nation. And these men, every one of them are outstanding. And just because some of them didn't write long prophecies, after all, you wouldn't want to call Elijah a minor prophet, would you? He'd be a mini-minor, because he never wrote any prophecy. If Elijah might be classified the first, John the Baptist, the last of the prophets, never wrote anything, and yet he was a prophet of God and announced the coming of the Savior. So that when we come here to the prophecy of Hosea, we're coming to one of the great books of the Bible. It actually belongs before Jeremiah. Hosea was contemporary with Isaiah and Micah, and also his compatriot in the northern kingdom, Joel. Hosea and Joel in the north, Isaiah and Micah in the southern kingdom. And this man, Hosea, would compare to Jeremiah. Jeremiah's the last prophet before the southern kingdom went into captivity. But over 100 years before that, Hosea had been the prophet in the northern kingdom, and he occupied the same position of warning the nation, and he did it with a broken heart. But his broken heart comes from an experience that he's had, and that's what we've been dealing with. You see, Jeremiah, his was personal, but nevertheless, it was more public. He loved his nation, and he was a tender-hearted man that broke his heart to have to give them a harsh message, but that's the kind of a man God chose. Now, I don't consider Hosea a tender-hearted man like Jeremiah, but this man had an experience. And as we've seen the past 2 days, he comes out of a broken home with a broken heart. And we're going into detail now into the text. And from that broken home and that broken heart, where a wife had been unfaithful to him and had become a harlot, he even loved her so much, he went back and took her again, and she played the harlot again. This man, with hot tears rushing down his cheeks, walks out before the nation, and he says, "I want to tell you how God feels about you, because I feel the same way. I've had a personal experience in my own home." And this man with a broken heart could speak to his nation, you see. Now, with that in mind, let's look here for just a few moments at the outline that we've made of this book. Very simple outline, actually, in just 2 major divisions. We have 14 chapters here, actually more than you have in the book of Daniel, yet we call this a minor prophet. And we have in the first 3 chapters that which is personal, and that's the prophet and his faithless wife, Gomer. It's the scandal of his home and the gossip of the town that we get in the first 3 chapters. Then we have the prophetic. It's the Lord and the faithless nation, Israel, from chapter 4 through 14.